This mother is struggling to get a hold of her son, who has been stranded in a forest on the border of Belarus and Poland for days. I am not feeling well mentally because my son is over there and I am not able to do anything, she says. Her 20-year-old son left their home in northern Iraq as thousands of migrants from the Middle East traveled to Belarusian cities and towns, then attempted to cross into the European Union. They've been left to freeze on the forest floor with winter closing in, unable to enter the EU or go back into Belarus. Polish police say the body of a young Syrian man was found Friday in the woods near the border, the eighth known victim to die in this crisis. The border is heavily guarded and fortified by Poland, which has accused Belarus of luring migrants by promising them easy access to Europe, a claim Belarus denies. European leaders do not recognize Alexander Lukashenko as the legitimate president of Belarus. His regime is under EU sanctions, and more sanctions could come into effect as soon as Monday. Russia, so far, standing by its ally. In an interview this weekend, President Vladimir Putin defended Lukashenko's handling of the migrant crisis, while also denying his country's involvement in it.
The Belarusian foreign minister on Sunday spoke on the phone with his EU counterpart about the migrant crisis, with the EU foreign policy chief tweeting he told Belarus people should not be used as weapons. As for the Belarusian side, it said it emphasized the futility of sanctions. The new sanctions are expected to target Belarusian officials as well as travel agencies and airlines thought to be involved in bringing migrants to the border. Caryn Ceolin, City News.